Okay. Now, this is important. This is a mistake a lot of players make. The ball will come in here, and then this player will float about straight down the floor. Well, if they're in a diamond, there's usually somebody sitting right up in here. And so if that's the pass you make, that guy will step in and get that. But if you run that sharp diagonal to the sideline, that angle is almost impossible to defend by either him or him. All right, now, after a while, they may say, we're tired of getting beat. If they continue with this press, okay, this guy has just been killing them. So now what you can do is, here's their diamond setup. We'll just kind of draw them in there. Okay, and then here's our one. So they're on top of him. This guy is kind of cheating over here. They're not going to let this guy have the ball anymore. I mean, they're just on top of it now. So he cuts through and they're there. So we'll do something different now. Now we'll send our two. Okay, so our one, and again, if they don't do a good job of denying, we'll throw the ball into him. But let's say they do. Let's say we can't get it to him in any way. We can't get it inbounds to him, and we can't get that diagonal. So after a while, we'll send two across here, and then one will break to the ball here and look for the basketball. Okay, so then we can hit two on the diagonal. If we did hit two on the diagonal, then one simply going to the middle of the floor. That's his rules. So then one would simply go to the middle because two is running the sideline diagonal. So again, the key is don't let these two players cut straight down the floor if the ball is on their side. They have to run a sharp, straight diagonal to that sideline. And then the rule for them that I have, and I think is a good rule, is if he gets the ball here, let's say two gets the ball here from four, no more than two dribbles down this sideline. And then the ball has to go to the middle, either on the dribble or on the pass. So if one had broken into the middle here, he's obviously filling the middle, and then we can throw the ball to him, and our five should be standing on that block at that point. So if he can't hit one, or you know, if he makes a decision right away, I'm going to the middle, then one would simply fill in behind him. So if one guard goes to the middle with the dribble, the other guard should fill in behind them, so we have those lanes filled. Okay, and then your three would trail here, and four would trail there. You have all your lanes filled. You have your trail lanes filled, and you're in perfect position on the break to score. Now, if you'd like to learn more about this topic, just click down in the description. There's a link to our rental DVDs and coaching videos where you can learn from the absolute best coaches in the game more about this topic. And you'll master any topic in basketball that you want to by watching our instructional videos.